Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel and welcome to any newbies. And if you're new here today, if you like the videos, please consider to hit like, subscribe. I really appreciate it. So anyway, let's get started. This is pick a card. I've shuffled and pulled out some fortune cookies for you, even though they don't look like fortune cookies, but they are fortune cookie cards. So pile one, we've got clear quartz, love heart, clear quartz. Pile two, we've got carnelian, and pile three, we have jade. So I'll let you choose your pile, and don't forget guys, take what resonates, leave what doesn't, and if it's not your pile, choose another pile. And don't forget, these are energies as well, so if the king of swords comes out, it can be female, because as I said, their energy. So anyway, I'll see you at your piles. So pile one, if you chose clear quartz and pile one, this is your reading. So let's have a look at what your fortune cookie says. It says surprise. A disappointment will be followed by a pleasant surprise. An invitation could bring love to those searching. Okay. And then we've got health, an excellent time to start an exercise program or diet. Many new friendships are on the horizon. Manifestations, a bountiful time awaits you. Your wishes could manifest right before your eyes. Oh, I like this part one. This is really positive. So from your free cards, what I'm getting here is ignore the sniffles and you know, the crackly voice. So surprise here. Something disappointed you. It could have been someone that you had your eye on, or it could have been someone that you were interested in and it didn't work out. Now, from what I'm getting from this card here, I think there's going to be a surprise that's coming to you by the person that you felt disappointed with. Because it says a surprise invitation could bring love to those searching. So you're obviously searching for love. It could be, like I said, you had your eye on someone and it didn't work out. But it's like you're manifesting love into your life. But I feel like you're mainly manifesting this person. And Spirit is saying it's right here. It's ready. You're nearly there. And health. It could even be that you've met this person in the gym. It could be someone that you've been flirting with in the gym. or it could be that you may need to get your health in order. Maybe need a new diet. Start eating healthily. But who am I to judge? I don't do none of that. Oh, I'd like to, but I've got no willpower. Anyway, so let's have a look at these cards. I'm going to use kipper first, and then we're going to go on to tarot for you, my lovely part ones. So Spirit, tell us about this surprise. I'm mainly zoomed in on that surprise. Tell us about this surprise for part one. Oh wow, thank you Spirit. Oh, look at this, look at me getting all excited. Anyone think this is my bloody reading? Look at this. Why are my cards upside down? So you have the main male, and then you have the lovers. I love this. So the lovers cards can represent summertime. So it could be up to 15 weeks to summer. That's the card of the lovers in the kipper deck. Now the main male is actually the main person. So you've got the main female, which would be you guys, the collective, whether you're female, male, it doesn't really matter, or female. But this is the love interest that's coming into your life here that you've been manifesting. I like this. Give me a bit more here, Spirit. Tell me a bit more about this main male and lovers. Tell me more about the main male and the lovers. Despair. Let's get one more. Don't put off by despair, guys, okay? I'll explain it in a minute when I get one more. Mm. more, please, Spirit. Thank you. Okay. This is great. I love this. Okay. So, with the first card that came out with your fortune cookie here, that you were disappointed and you had your eye on someone, and that's what I feel for you guys, pile one. But it didn't, nothing happened. And I still feel for some of you, you do have your eye on this person, and this person is the one that you're manifesting into your life, or it could be someone totally different to this person. This actually really upset you. It caused despair. I mean, despair is like depression, you know, being up inside your head, things not going your way. And it brought a lot of disappointment. But what Spirit is saying, it's in the early stages. I mean, even though it says child, it can be children, but this is actually saying in the Kipper deck that this is in the early stages at the moment. And when you meet this main male, it's going to happen suddenly. I hope you can see that, because I've actually moved my ring light. It's going to happen very suddenly, okay? And you're going to spend a lot of intimate moments with this person. You're going to share, you know, deep feelings, some naughty times together. So yeah, there's a lot of intimate moments coming with this main male here. But don't be in despair. It could be you guys are at this stage where you're like, oh my God, when is it going to happen? When am I going to meet my person? Spirit saying, be patient. It's happening within 15 weeks to summertime. And it's still early days yet. And also, Spirit wants you to take things slow. Don't rush when you meet this person. Don't try and run 100 miles an hour. So let's get to the tarot cards. I want more on this main male and lover's spirit, please. Tell me more from a pile one. Tell me a bit more for my pile one. Tell us more about the main male and the lovers. Look, here's the despair card again. This is your overall energy here. You're in this energy of feeling so... This wounded you as well with the Nine of Wands. But this is all in your head. You're all up in your head at the moment. You're worrying about when is it going to happen. You're worrying about whether this person's going to see you, whether they're going to give you a chance or not. But this is all your own paranoia. Your own insecurities, and I'm not having a go at you, this is what the tarot cards are saying, okay? But this really wounded you. You felt rejected. But you're still standing your ground, you're still quite being stubborn about it, that you want this with this person. So I am getting more of a strong vibe that you're still interested in this main male here. So, but yeah, you're still in this energy of despair, Nine of Swords, despair. You know, this has caused you a lot of sleepless nights. I think you've actually cried over this as well. You feel really rejected by this main male, but there could be a reason. Let's see why they rejected you, but they are coming. You've got the Page of Swords, the Chariot, the Devil. Now, the Page of Swords is delayed news, so this is delayed. The child says early stages anyway. And it could be that you are spying on them, or it could be that they're maybe asking around about you, maybe checking in to see what you're up to. So I do feel an interest here. But what's happening here, guys, is you're getting a bit... I shouldn't even say it, but I'm a tarot reader, I have to say it. You're getting a bit obsessed, okay? This obsession with stalking this person, not meaning that you're a stalker and, you know, you're outside their house in the car with your bandana on and your hat and, you know, your glasses. I'm not going down that road. I could just see you guys, pile one, actually doing that. But no, that's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is it's taking over your energy. You're becoming obsessed with trying to find out what this main male is up to. Instead of letting it play out, leave it into the universe's hands, you know, you're not. You're obsessing. You know, you want this person to come towards you, you know, quickly. You want them to take action. and this has become an obsession with you, that this is all you're constantly thinking about. If you can hear noises in the background, sorry, that's my partner that's in a meeting and he's got a big gob, so you may hear noises in the background, and I do apologise. Anyway, so yeah, let's tell me more about this main male spirit. What's his next move towards my pile one? What are the next moves? Queen of Wands, Six of Swords, Seven of Wands. See, the Queen of Wands, their energies, okay, can be male. They're very passionate, very fiery, and they're a go-getter. And when they're ready to come get you, sounds wrong, but when they're ready to come forward, you know, and pursue you, they will, in their own time, though. Because at the moment, there is something, and there's something going on with this main male here, and I'm not being told what it is. It's like the spirit doesn't want me to know, doesn't want you to know, by the looks of it. It could even be with the children here. It could be they're dealing with children at the moment. Maybe they've split up from someone and they're trying to put their children first. For some of you, if that resonates, take that. If not, throw it out. So they're trying to pave way for a smooth sailing ahead with you. They don't want to bring trouble on your doorstep. They want it to be smooth sailing, because if he brings crap into your relationship, that's just going to end up, you know, ruining it. But you are going to have an intimacy with this main male here that you've never experienced with anyone before. You're going to share a lot of feelings, you're going to have a lot of deep conversations. You're going to feel like it's like a soulmate connection. But this main male is really being firm and stubborn in his ways at the moment, that no, he's not coming forward till he's ready. I know that sounds really horrible, but he's not being horrible. He's trying to be nice for himself, for whoever he's dealing with, whatever he's dealing with, and for you as well. He finds you very sexy. He finds you very beautiful. He loves your independence. You know, he loves the way you own the room. It's that confidence that he's very attracted to, pile one, as well as your looks, because my Queen of Wands and my King of Wands are the most good looking ones in the deck. I'm sorry to say it, guys. I'm not even a fire sign myself. I'm an air sign. I'm the Ice Queen. Which is the Queen of Swords. So yeah, he's remaining firm. And in a way, guys, Spirit is saying you should actually respect this person, this main male, for actually doing that and not dragging you into their dramas. But you've got to get over this obsession, okay? Just relax, is what Spirit is saying. Relax, relax. What else does my pile ones need to know about this situation? Whew, pile one. What else do they need to know, Spirit? What they need to know to be reassured, that might help. Oh, goodness, mate. Too many. What do they need to know to be reassured? Four of Pentacles. The Empress, right? What Spirit wants you to know is they do really like you, okay? This could be someone that could be possessive, it could be someone that's not letting go, someone that's a miser, you know, holding on to someone quite tightly, and they are holding on to you. They're not telling you this. Maybe they have told you this, that they don't want to let you go, they're still holding on, and that's what Spirit is saying. And it's also what I'm getting from Spirit as well, is wait. This is all I keep hearing, is wait. They see you as the Empress. They see you as the Divine Feminine here. And this is what I'm saying, they love, they actually really, I think they're in awe of you. You know, when they look at you, they're like, wow, you know, I can't believe someone like this actually likes me. they love your character. You're even though you're fiery, and we've got Gemini, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius here. We've got Capricorn as well. We've got Gemini, Libra, Aquarius as well. So yeah, anyway, back to the Empress. When they look at you, they cannot believe that you are someone that is, it's like you're too good to be true. And I do fear that they are a bit fearful that you may give up on them. They want, this is why the Four of Pentacles came out. Hold on, don't let go yet. Because I do feel like you're at the stage that, because you're in the Nine of Swords and you're really heartbroken and they're not making a decision at the moment. They're not moving forward. They're not moving the relationship forward. You're about to give up. But they don't want you to give up. All right. Spirit, what advice would you have for my pile ones? Wow. Yay. Eight of Wands. Five of Pentacles, Four of Cups. Right, okay, it's part one. You are so fearful that this energy is just gonna... Right, there's two scenarios I'm seeing here. It could be that out of nowhere, this person spoke to you and told you they can't give you what you want right now. And for others of you, it's the fear of being rejected. It's the fear of being left out in the cold. It's you're feeling devastated. When you got this message, for some of you, you felt devastated because you felt rejected. The other half of you, it could be that you are fearing that this message is going to come and they're going to reject you. Because the Four of Cups is even speaking of rejection. So you are feeling rejected at the moment. So tell me about this Eight of Wands. What is this communication here? Eight of Wands. Oh, heck. Nine of Cups, Three of Pentacles. Look, Eight of Swords again. You're all up in your head. This is paranoia speaking here with you guys. This is what you're fearing. You're fearing the worst. You know, the Eight of Wands isn't about rejection. When this person does finally reach out to you, they're going to offer you this wish fulfillment, this success, this, you know, contentment. The Nine of Cups is all about your wishes being granted. You know, you've got the manifestation there that says that it's on its way to you. The Three of Pentacles is a reunion. It can be reconciliation. It could be collaboration with other people. It could be working with someone. But yeah, you know, you could even work with this person. Maybe that's why you find it so hard. For some of you, that's not all of you. Tell me about the Nine of Cups. Death. Three of Wands. Knight of Cups. Okay, look. You didn't get your wish fulfillment at the beginning, but Spirit is saying that is still there. You just have to give it time, okay? Things ended before they even got started with the death here. But don't forget, death is like an ending and a new beginning. It's like a transition. So it could be you're coming out of this stagnant situation, out of this not being together, you know, moving things forward, basically. And this is what you want. And this is what Spirit is saying. You've been waiting for quite a while, Pile One. I don't blame you feeling like this. You've been waiting and waiting and waiting, and you've been yearning for this person with the Three of Wands. You've got the Knight of Cups on the back of the deck, speaks of somebody that is coming forward, someone that's going to be communicating their love to you, communicating their feelings to you. You know, this is a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Death is Scorpio as well. So, yeah, this... this communication, this forward movement that's going to come out of nowhere is I feel like the death is about to come to an end. The ending is about to come to an end, if you know what I mean. Tell me about the death. You know, you have been waiting for a long time, some of you. Could, like, maybe be a few months, even up to a year. Tell me about the death. Tell me about death. Wow. Stubborn energy. Tell me about the death, please, spirit. Tell me about this death. Nine of Pentacles. Justice. Yeah, look, they know they have to make a decision and they have to do it soon. They know that maybe time's running out. Maybe you've told them that time's running out, or they feel like they've been taking too long where they've not done anything about this connection here. The Two of Wands spirit is, what this energy is coming to the conclusion, they know they have to make a decision. They know they have to make the right choice for themselves. And they're choosing this. They have to choose a path and they have to stick with it, is what spirit's saying. Justice is all about making decisions as well. You know, doing right by you, doing, you know, making things right by you. It also could be, this is destined, basically, of you two coming back together. The Nine of Pentacles speaks to someone that is very successful, someone's doing very well on their own. This speaks to someone that is single, and this could be you guys. Here, you know, you're single, you're just missing your 10th pentacle. They see the value in you here. They do. They know you're valuable. And the world, you know, that's closing of the chapter. But it's also starting again, you know, starting anew. Look, passionate new beginning here. And they're going to come to this conclusion, they are. They're going to put the effort in. Eight of Pentacles as well. Eight of Cups, so putting away, you know, you've got three eights here, so maybe look up angel number 888. But yeah, they're leaving behind things that they invested in, you know, people that don't mean anything to them anymore, you know, that they've wasted their time on. They're leaving it behind and they're coming forward to actually put effort in with you because they want a passionate new beginning with you. They don't want it to be, they don't want that, they want to start the chapter again, okay, with you, because they know you're valuable. They know you're loyal. They know you're sincere. And I feel like they want to give you this 10th pentacle, you know, because you've been single for a long while, pole two. I haven't even gone to pole two yet. Let's get some love messages, if I can find it. Right. So, Spirit, what love messages do you have for, okay, wedding? Past life relationship. This situation involves marriage. You have known each other before. Right, okay. This could be because the main male is married. The main male is dealing with children, you know, trying to close the chapter properly on the past relationship. You just saw with the Eight of Cups that they are walking away. They are leaving it behind. But the reason why things are at a standstill with you at the moment is because they need to put this to bed. And Spirit is saying you two have had past lives together. You know, this could be a soulmate connection here. Heart-to-heart conversations. Honesty. Discuss your feelings with each other. And that's the intimacy here. And this is what you two are both going to be doing. You're going to be both be discussing your feelings on a deep level. So, what more do you have, Spirit? Oh, is that too many? No, we'll take being asked. So we've got, it is safe for you to love. Open your heart to give and receive the highest energy of all. So Spirit is saying it might be that when this person comes back that you're a bit fearful because they've messed you around in the past, and they let you down and you were so devastated and they've put you in the Nine of Swords energy where you're, you know, you've shed a lot of tears, you've not slept properly, you're not even eaten well, pile one. You're so scared to give them another go, even though your heart really wants to. Your head is saying, do I trust this person? But spirit's saying, open your heart. It's safe to love this person. Finances and career. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. So like I said, it could be that they're sorting out finances to do with their children. You know, obviously alimony if they're getting a divorce, you know, that kind of thing. Because obviously this energy doesn't want to come, this main male doesn't want to come towards you with nothing to show for, you know, they don't want to, I'm going to say something there, but I can't start swearing on my channel now. even though I have in the past. They don't want to come forward empty-handed, okay? It could be they're getting their job in order. Maybe they're leaving their job. They want to transfer. Release your ex. This time has come to clear your energy. So spirit is saying to this main male here, it's time to release the ex. And that's what they're doing. Express your love. Go ahead and make the romantic gesture. So this is what... I feel like this is what he the main male, was about to do with you guys. Okay, so up to 15 weeks is what I'm seeing here, guys, if you want a timeline on it, okay, with the Kipper cards, you can tell with the timeline. So yeah, I'm going to leave it there. Actually, no, let's not leave it there, part one. Let's get some gems here, some, I can't even remember what they're freaking called now. Anyway, you know what I mean, once you start hearing it. Some letters and some... Oh my God, I'm having a brain fart. Anyway, you know what I mean, once you stick them in the bowl. So if you don't like the noise, turn it down now and, yeah. Right, lovely. So let's get your letters. We've got I. So this can be their initials. It can be something in their name. It can even be initials in your name, or it can make out a name or, you know, a place that you went to, whatever. So we've got I-O-I-O-U. I-I, that's a weird one. J, so we've got Joe. John, even though you can spell it like that. So... Is that an I? Yes. So I-I-J-O-N-Y, Johnny, T, John T, D for Don, and O again. So they could have that in their initials, they could have that in their name. If you can see a word there, you know, a word, a name in these letters here. So that's the letters. And then we've got, okay, do you know what, this is very weird, I've not seen this charm here, that's what they call charms, actually reminds me of the despair card, I don't know if you can see it, I'm not sure, but even the clothing, the coat, the trousers, the boots. So this is you, you're feeling in despair. It could even be that the main male is the one that's in despair here as well, because they feel like you're slipping away. They feel like time is running out and they know they've got to act soon. You know, because you can't expect people to wait around for you forever. You know, I mean, freaking heck, really? That's not reality. So this is what I'm seeing here. They're in despair. We've got an anchor here. An anchor brings stability and security into your life. So this is a secure connection here. This is someone that will be stable, that will make you feel secure in the connection. Then we've got the dragonfly here. The dragonfly is all about wishes being granted. It's something that's about to take flight. Your manifestations about to take flight, your wishes about to take flight, something's about to happen here. You've got the heart here, so obviously you hold their heart, there's love involved here with both of you. You've got the angel here, which I see this as, that it's being divinely guided. You two are being brought back together. And then we've got the cat. The black cat, the cat is all about luck. Even though, like, you know, people think, oh God, witchcraft, da 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 da. It's about good luck. So good luck is on the way to you here. We've got another angel here. Yeah, this is definitely, they're both the same. How weird's that? I've never had two the same come out. Yeah, you're being, your angels are pushing, their angels, your angels are actually pushing you back towards one another. We've got the mouth. So there could be gossip about you, gossip about this situation. It could be that when you end up together, it may be that maybe someone from their part is going to end up not being happy about this, and there's going to be a lot of gossip and a lot of backlash. This reminds me of the five of wands. There we go again. You're protected again. I forgot what this is called. It's like the evil eye, but it's not. It's a thingy hand, I forgot what it's called, but anyway, you're protected. This is actually very, it's protected so well by the divine here. You've got your angels, you've got your hand, you've got your cat, and then you've got the unicorn here. And these are all about wishes and happiness. You know, unicorns is happy, and it's like fairy tale, and that's what I feel like it's going to be like for you two. Not in a stupid way, not in a childish way, as I'm saying it. It's going to feel like you can't believe your dreams have come true. So I'm going to leave it there, pile one. I hope this resonated for you, and if you like the video, please hit like, and I will see you soon. Bye. Hey, pile two. So if you chose citrine, this is your reading here. If you can hear voices in the background, that's my hubby in a meeting. His office is next door to mine, so I do apologise. You know, it's got a bit of a big mouth, but anyway. So let's get your fortune cookies, and then we'll go with the kipper, and then we'll go with the tarot cards, okay? So your fortune cookie pile two is reinvent yourself. A transformation is taking place. Enjoy a new lease of life. Nature. Interact with nature in the outdoors, around animals, farmlands, or by the ocean. This will be good for the soul and healing for you. Intuition. Trust your intuition. It's a great time to learn a new skill, change careers, or invest in money. Okay, this is totally a different reading for pile one. So it could be that you're at this stage in your life that you're in a job and you're really bored with it. It could be that you're wanting to branch out on your own, pile two. And spirit is saying, reinvent yourself. If that's what you want to do, it'll bring a new lease of life into your world, basically. It could be that what the problem is with you at the moment, you're not grounded. This is why it's saying go out, interact with nature. Try and do some grounding meditation if you can. Or be at one with nature. Put some meditation on while you're out in nature. You know, if you're taking a walk in the woods. Because what spirit is saying here is, if you get out in nature, the ideas will start flowing towards you. You know, it will start giving you the ideas and the inspiration that you need to move into what it is that you want to do. Your intuition has been very strong lately to do this, but you're doubting that intuition. You know, it could be that you want to go back to school, you want to learn a new skill here, you know, career and investments. It could be that you want to invest in something, but you're ignoring your intuition, okay? So my pile two, you could actually be like the high priestess that does have strong psychic abilities, you know, clairvoyance. Your intuition is usually spot on, but you've lost that along the way. Maybe that's why you need to go out in nature and find that again. Maybe do some grounding meditation, like I said. Let's get some kipper cards for you guys. So spirit, tell us about this reinvent yourself for my pile two. Gift and bad health. So So I need one more for bad health. Actually, no, I need a couple more. Tell me more about this bad health. Concern. Tell me about this gift. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay. On the house. Right. Okay, you've got someone mature around you. It's a man. Can be female if you know, just swap it around if you feel like it. But with the mature man, he's an older age, like so maybe 40s and upwards. Maybe late 30s, and their health has not been doing very well. But this also could be you guys, okay? This could be because you're not feeling very well, you're feeling depressed maybe, and this is why Spirit is saying to you to get out more. It could be that you're locked away behind a desk and you know you're wasting away back there, and you know you're letting life pass you by instead of pursuing what you're passionate about. Now there's a gift coming towards you, so this could be a gift from the Most High, it could be a gift that has been given to you by somebody, but you know, we've got the main female here as well. I'm also seeing something as well, guys, that I don't know whether to say, because, you know, I mean, even though my readings are for 18 and upwards, but, you know, because sometimes with the health card, even though it says bad health, it doesn't necessarily mean bad health. It can mean other things as well, you know, the bedroom stuff, the fun stuff in the bedroom is what I'm going to phrase it like that. So it could be that you're having some fun stuff with the mature male here because you are the main female, okay? For some of you, can be the main male, the mature male. And I feel like your energy is being sucked away by this thief, which is the mature man, because you know, I feel I'm picking up energy vampire here. Maybe they're too demanding in the bedroom. You know, for some of you, take that if that resonates. If not, chuck it out the window. But I need to know what's being stolen. Tell me about this thief, Spirit, please. Tell me about the thief. Wife. Oh, no. Thank you, Spirit. Okay, you're involved with somebody here. You're involved with this mature male, okay? And, you know, you have the fun stuff in the bedroom. But there is a problem here. Why I said energy vampire, I feel like this main male, I feel like he's older than you guys, pile two, okay? And doesn't have to be, but I'm picking up more mature than you. And his problem is, because you want to now branch out and you want to go off and reinvent yourself, they feel like they're losing you, right? So they're getting all official on you, you know, bossy, because the official person is someone in the military, it's someone in a high position, and also could be someone that is quite militant, that can be quite strict with the rules, right? So with the official person, he's starting to put in rules and regulations now because they're so fearful of losing you, because the thief is, when the child is pickpocketing the man here and passing it to her that's distracting the man, whatever's on the left of the card, which is expectation, is usually what is being stolen. So this main male feels like you know, expects you to just go off and forget about them. Which is actually really, really stupid. Maybe you are part two fed up with your connection here. Maybe you do want to go off on your own. Maybe you've had enough of being told what to do, you know, being controlled. I'm picking up controlling energy here. I am. And I feel like they manipulate you quite a bit by giving you things like gifts and, you know, treating you well. They do treat you well, but it's not enough. Because I feel like you're losing yourself. That's the thief as well. You know there's more out there for you. So let's look a bit more into this main, mature male, man. Spirit, tell us about this mature man, please. Tell us a bit more. And the thing is, because the theme, the main, God's sake, this retrograde, I can't wait till it's over. Right, okay, let's start again. You guys are suffering with headaches at the moment as well, because the bad health, when it's sitting on top of the main male or the main female's head, it means headaches. So you're suffering with either depression, you're suffering with your mental health, you're suffering with headaches. Could be that you're suffering with sleepless nights, and this is being caused by the main male, okay? Now, there's a bit of a gap between you two as well, because she's down here, you're down here, he's up there, and there's a gap between the both of you. And when that happens in the Kipper cards, that means you're not really seeing eye to eye. Or it could just be that there's a bit of a gap between both of you, that you're a bit of coldness, because they're putting too much pressure on you. They're making you feel stressed, which is really not fair. Wow, thank you, Spirit. I absolutely love you when you do that. Thank you. Yes. Freaking heck. Okay. So we just clarified the mature man, okay? And it's just basically just said exactly what I've been saying with the Kipper cards, right? This mature man is causing so many burdens, so much stress. You know, you're constantly worried about whether you're going to upset them or whether you're doing the right thing. And it's like you can't seem to do anything right with this mature man. Unless you do what they tell you to do, which is the official person. You know, the rules. You follow the rules. You do as you're told. You know, he makes life hard for you. So you're feeling suffocated by this mature male. It's like he doesn't want to listen to what you've got to say, you know. Then we have the Page of Swords. This mature male watches everything that you do. So if you're not aware of this, and this came out in my reading yesterday. Was it yesterday? In one of the piles? Yes, it did. It's like I'm getting crossovers through my readings. But it must be some of you guys coming back that, you know, are my regulars that are watching this. So there's more messages here for you. Obviously he doesn't want me to talk. Hang on. Fucking hell. I will be talking. So yeah, maybe this is why my throat started going a bit funny there, because he doesn't want you to know that he's actually spying on you, that he might have your phone tapped, you know, that you can clone a mobile phone. He's listening on things that you're doing, people that you're talking to. He spies on your social media accounts. So, yeah, he's got his eye on you. And look at the way she's looking at the sword as well, guys. It's like, my precious. You know? You're mine. And on the back of the deck here, the overall energy on the back of the deck is the Five of Swords. You know, you feel defeated. If you just like, it's not your you're not being heard. You feel constantly attacked by this mature man. Wow. Tell us a bit more. Tell me about the thief, please, Spirit. Eight of Swords, Temperance. Magician, manipulation. This mature man has you so up in your head about everything. You feel like you're trapped. You feel like you can't get out. You're not able to see a way around this. You know, you want to pursue your dreams. You want to do more for yourself. It could be that you want to go back to school and they're not allowing you, you know, to do this, because it could be a controlling situation that you're in, a controlling relationship, and they manipulate you. It's like they mess with your, they play games with your mind, is what I'm picking up here. And even though the Temperance is all about inner peace and balance and harmony, they don't bring this to your life. They're taking that away from you. This is what the thief is. It's like the mature male is sucking this out of you. You're not in alignment with yourself. And this is why spirit wants you to get back out in nature, you know, find that alignment. And the thing is as well with the thief, with the expectation, it's like, you know that they're going to continue to do this. You know that it's never going to change. It's really sad. Tell me, okay, I didn't need to say anything, Hermit. So it could be that this person has you in seclusion, that you, look, Five of Swords again, yeah, look, you, I feel like you don't, you're not, this is really, really sad, Pile Two. I feel like you're being controlled that much that you're not even allowed to go out on your own. You're not allowed to be out of this mature man's sight. That you're in seclusion, you're away from people, you don't see people, you know, you're not allowed to communicate with people. And I'm telling you, one of my piles yesterday was exactly this. I can't remember if it was pile one or two. I think it was pile one, I think it was. I think it was yesterday's reading. Anyway. So yeah, you're being secluded, you know. Spirit wants you to admit that this is not going anywhere. If this has come out twice now, you know, you're going to have to admit defeat. If you want to put yourself first and you want to get back out there and, you know, you want to reinvent yourself and you want to get away from this toxic, mature man, you need to admit to yourself that this is not going anywhere. So what advice would you give my Pile 2 spirit in regards to this situation? I feel really drained, like really tired all of a sudden. And I was full of beans in Pile 1. And I feel like that's your energy, guys. The Eight of Swords energy is exactly that. The Hierophant. The Magician. Knight of Pentacles. Look, I like this. Spirit's advice to you, okay, with the Hierophant and with the Magician. You look at the way she's studying here. Spirit wants you to study, go do listen to your intuition, go for what it is that you want to do, because you have the tools to do this. You are a powerful manifestor here, you know how to get what you want, even if you have to use a bit of manipulation. Spirit is saying, do it, use that manipulation if it gets you what you want. You know, if you have to be a bit deceitful, if you have to wear a mask around this mature man, if it gets you to do this, you know, to study. But I do feel like spirit wants you to get more in touch with your spiritual side as well, because you are ignoring your intuition here. They've been screaming at you, your spirit guides, but you're not listening to them. Now look, we've got two cards here where they're both writing. They're both writing here. And this is, I feel like I'm getting strong energy here that you want to go study, but this mature man doesn't want you to, you know, because they provide for you. That's with the gift. They want you at home where they can keep an eye on you all the time, and you've been yearning to do this for such a long time, because the Knight of Pentacles is a long time. But spirit is saying, you know, if you take action, you're on your way to calmer waters here. You're on a way of putting yourself back together and putting yourself first. Wow, the Star, Aquarius energy here What else have we got here? We've got Taurus. We've got Sagittarius, Virgo, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius as well. Aquarius, strong Aquarius here. And then we've got Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn here. So we've got quite a lot of Virgo going on in here. Anyway, you are your own I've literally gone blank. Oh, that's what I was going to say. Two manifestation cards here. You are very powerful. You can make your dreams come true. You know, this is success. This is your dreams and your wishes being answered here, you know. And you can follow your dreams if that's it, that's what you want. Wow, High Priestess. I think I said it at the beginning about the High Priestess. You are really powerful. You've got the Magician, you've got the Star, you've got the High Priestess, okay? You've got a gift. It could even be that you want to learn something like this, you know, why not? It could be that you want to get into the mystical things, you know, with the Hierophant. It's all about spiritual, it's learning the spiritual side of religion, if you want to put it like that. But yeah, I love this for you, Paul, too. You are, but I feel like this mature male blocks your gift. I've had that. My gift, I mean, I've had my gift for nearly 50. So, I discovered my gift when I think I was 15. Yeah, 15. Fucking hell, a long time. Jesus, where's time freaking gone? But it went to sleep. I call it went to sleep for 5 years. I totally forgot I even had a gift on one day. I don't know. I'm going on about whatever, but I thought this might help you. One day I had a dream about somebody that I used to know and I haven't seen for nearly 40 years, and they meant a lot to me. And where I dreamt of that person, they awakened something the next morning when I woke up, and it was just like, where I was blinded to everything that was going on in my life. I mean, I wasn't in a good place myself. And I overlooked so many things that was just right there. My intuition went to sleep, but bloody hell, when I woke up that next day, everything just come rushing back. I actually started to feel quite ill as well, because it was that intense with what was being screamed at me. You know, I hadn't touched my tarot cards. I hadn't touched, you know, my kipper cards for 2 years. My other cards, I mean, they're really old. I might actually use them on a reading one day, but I've had them for nearly 30 years and they're quite mangled, but I love them. But yeah, I hadn't touched tarot cards for 5 years. And then something awakened in me, and it was just like I had to go back to doing what I've always done. So yeah. And this is what I feel like has happened to you. You're asleep at the moment and that needs to be awakened, or it could be that you are being awakened. I think you are coming out of this deep sleep that you're in. So that, you know, I thought I'd share that story with you guys because it just feels like a bit like close to home. So anyway, what more advice would you have for my Pearl 2 spirit? What more advice would you give my Pearl 2? Oh, Jesus. I'll take those two. Queen of Cups. Queen of Swords. Air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Seven of Cups. Spirit's advice to you is stop being emotional when it comes to this mature man. Stop using your heart and start using your head. Spirit says you are very intelligent because that is the Queen of Swords, and Spirit's saying that this person has deeply hurt you, like you know, the hurt runs deep, really deep. And I feel like you're starting to turn cold towards this person. It's like you've got a wall up. It's like you don't trust this person. You see through what they're doing to you, because that is the Queen of Swords. She is very intelligent like that. She'll be more practical, more logical. She'll use her head. Oh, and she can see when she's being deceived. And this is where I think you're coming out of this deep freeze. Look, she's the Ice Queen here. You're coming out of this deep freeze. You're going to start taking back your power here. You have so many options out there, is what Spirit is saying. And you just need to choose the option that you want to go, what you want to do with yourself, or where you want to go, or wherever, you know, it takes you. The choice is yours. So many options here, and you're weighing up these options, you know, and hopefully soon you'll come to a decision. So any more advice? Star again, guys. The Star and the Ten of Wands. No, the Three of Wands. Oh. Look, you want something so badly. You really do want to go off and do what it is that you're so passionate about, and you can do this because the Star's there. You're yearning for this. You are really, really, like, it's like you're looking at it from afar. It's like you feel like it's not possible. You feel like, it's like you've got no confidence in yourself, because you feel like you may get rejected. You may not get accepted on a course if that's what you want to do with, if it's to do with studying, it may be to do with a job. You feel like you're just going to be rejected. But Spirit is saying, no, you're not going to be rejected. That's your own insecurity here. And you are bored with your lot at the moment. You're bored with your life. You feel dissatisfied. They're not bringing you any satisfaction, this mature male. Okay. You feel betrayed, you feel let down by this person. But it's not just that you feel betrayed, you are so hurt. You've gone through so much with this mature man. And it's like you've got this fear about you, that you feel like you just, you know, can I start again? Can I do this for myself? But Spirit's saying you can. You've got a second chance here from the divine here, you know. There's better love out there. It's time to love yourself. You know, start following your passion. Start doing things that you love. So, let's get... I was going to use the love thingy, but we're not really looking at love, are we? So, let's get some closing messages for you. We have truth. Yeah, the truth has been shown to you. You've already can see the truth. It's just, it's accepting the truth, isn't it? All the truth is going to be revealed to you. Then you've got clear your aura. There you go. Get out in nature. Do some grounding. Do some meditation. I feel like this is an energy vampire here, and it's like they suck the life out of you, and it's like they're all up in your aura. So what you need to do is a protection meditation here, because I do that because I do readings and I don't want to grab hold of everybody's energy when you like guys come in here, and I don't mean that in a bad way because it does affect me. So, you know, you do the cleansing meditation, you know, the aura cleansing as well, and you need to protect yourself as well. And you can find them on YouTube if you don't know where to look for them. And the best one that I use all the time, and I've used her for years, is Nikki Sutton. Nikki Sutton. She's very popular on YouTube, and I love her voice. She's very soothing. Mm-hmm. So then we've got Shadow Treasures here. So Shadow Treasures. I feel like you're starting to dig, and you're starting to see what is actually affecting you in life is the mature man and other things that they're doing here. So it's like the shadows are slowly being revealed to you, you know, with the lights here, like the little, what they called those, fireflies here. It's like it's lighting the way, it's showing you all the shadows, the darkness in your life. And then you've got relief. You're going to look at the bliss on her face. You're going to feel relief. And on the back of the deck, here we go again, practical intuition. So please work on your intuition, guys, because you guys are really powerful, okay? I mean, if anything, you know, bloody hell. I just, maybe some of you don't even know that you've got this, a gift. Maybe you need to look into it more. So I'm going to leave it there, pile two. So if this resonated for you, please hit like and comment if you feel like commenting. And you guys, pile two, please look after yourselves. And I hope your dreams and wishes come true. Bye. Hey, pile three, so if you chose Jade, this is your reading and this is your fortune cookie. So let's have a look. Love. Love is in the air. A great time for commitment and taking relationships to the next level. Then we've got commitment. Wow. A commitment is indicated around love or business. It will make you feel better. Wow. Okay. And then major life change. Time is right for major life changes as a new lifestyle or location brings great joy and trouble-free existence. Wow, pile three. Lovely. Lovely, jubbly. So, what we're seeing here is like blatantly in our faces here. It's basically you've got love coming towards you, or it could be that you've already met this person, or if you're looking for love, love is on its way to you and it's going to be a deeper commitment. It's going to be on a different level to what you're used to. And this is going to bring, you know, you're both going to be committed to one another and it's going to make you feel so much better because maybe you've just not had good relationships in the past. But this is going to bring a major life, a change to your life is what Spirit is saying. It could be that you may have, like it says, moving. It may be that you may have to move with this person, or you decide to both move together. But you've got joy ahead of you and... you know, trouble is just going to just disappear. Maybe you've gone through a lot in your life and it's about time that this is, you know, this is karmic justice basically for you guys. So let's have a look. I'm really like this. Tell me about this love and commitment, please, Spirit. Use the kipper deck first. Occupation, despair, child, journey. Yeah, I feel like with you guys, when you, if you haven't met this person yet, or if you've met this person, take what resonates, that it's something, it could be that you've met this person through work, or it could be that because of their job, you're going to have to leave everything behind, you know, friends, family, because you love this person, you want to be with this person. And it's causing you a lot of despair here, a lot of heartache, basically. It could be... you may suffer with migraines as well, with despair. That it's a migraine card as well. We've got children here. I want to clarify the child. So yeah, you're going on this new journey here. You're on this journey with somebody. But I feel like it could be that you could travel with work as well, because occupation's here where you meet this person. Tell me more about this child. You've got the lovers, you've got the main male, yeah, you've got someone coming into you, yep, look, change, you've got major change coming towards you here, guys. It could be that you have to give up a job to be with this person, something that you love doing, you know, you're worrying, it's causing you stress. Despair doesn't necessarily mean that, oh my God, I'm in despair like the Ten of Swords, it just means that it's giving you... you're suffering with a lot of mental tension at the moment. You've got the lovers here. You've got the main male. You've got the distant horizons. And then you've got... so, this change brings about a wish fulfillment here with the main male. Okay, this main male here is someone that's in love. You're in love. This can happen in the summertime because the lovers is 15 weeks from now, or the summertime. But I feel like you're both going on a journey together here. There's a big change coming into your life here, pile three. It's going to literally turn your world upside down, but in a good way, not in a bad way at all. So tell me about this. Tell me about this despair. It keeps jumping at me. I need to check this despair. Nine of Wands was in reverse. I can't see these cards. I don't even know why I bloody chose them. Six of Wands. Tell me more about the Nine of Wands in reverse. Nine of Wands is a wounded warrior. You know, having to protect yourself. But when it's in reverse, it's like you're finally out of this woundedness. Like, you know, you're not feeling sad anymore. You're not feeling like you have to protect yourself. Ten of Wands. What is going on? Tell me more. Oh, fucking hell. All right, spirit. I said tell me more, but Jesus. Oh. Okay. I think this is someone that's coming back from your past. Someone that's, same energies keep coming through. You were disappointed in the past when it came to a certain someone. It could be that you had to leave to go and work somewhere. You had to leave it behind. And it was in the early stages of the relationship. And this caused you a lot of despair because you had to leave the main male behind. And it could be that you've not seen this person for a while, because the distant horizons can be like a long time. It can be, you know, someone that's so far away from you. So you are apart from each other. But there's a big change coming, and you're on this journey of love together is what I'm seeing. I'm going to clarify the love and the main male in a minute. So we've got the Nine of Pentacles, the Nine of Wands in reverse, which is, as I said, upright. It's the Wounded Warrior. It's feeling hurt, it's needing to protect ourselves. But when it's reversed, it's the opposite of that. It's like you're not wounded anymore. It's like you've healed from this. You do carry around some of the wounds. You do carry around some of the, it's like you're haunted by what happened or what could have been. Because look at the watermelons that they're carrying, these heavy sacks, baskets on their back here. So you still do carry it around with you, but I don't think you're on your own here. I feel like the main male carries it as well, because it's got two people in it. You've got a boy and a girl here. So then you've got the knight. Oh no, it's the last card, sorry. You've got the Three of Swords here. So it could have been that this main male may have could have cheated on you. There could have been a third party, someone else involved. It could be that it was unrequited love. But what I'm seeing here is the relationship broke down. It was like a separation between both of you. Okay, and you've still carried that around with you to this day, that you never got over losing this main male. Okay, then you've got the Two of Swords here. Not by being able to see what's coming, not being able to see a solution to a problem, being blinded to something. But what I feel is that you don't see coming, what's coming towards you is this Knight of Cups. The Knight of Cups is someone that has a romantic offer, a romantic proposal. It's someone that's coming forward with their, to speak their romantic feelings to you, you know, express their love for you. They have a cup of love. Let's have a look at this. And you know, and this is forward movement. This is like a journey. This is, it could be that maybe you go away and you bump into this person, or it could be that, you know, that this person is rushing towards you. This is forward movement, you know, move energy that's moving, that's coming towards you. Tell me about the Knight of Cups. So we've got Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces here. Tell me about the Knight of Cups. Knight of Swords, action. This person's taking action towards you. This is a go-getter. This is someone that is, I'm coming forward, I'm coming to speak to you, and I'm going to bring about a big change in your life. It's someone that is willing to take a risk. We have the Emperor. This is an Emperor, the Divine Masculine that's coming towards you. Of air sign Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. We have Aries, strong Aries energy here. So you have an Emperor coming towards you. This is someone that, you know, when they make up their mind, they go for it. It's someone that knows what they want. It could even be that this could eventually become your husband or your wife. You know, it can be female as well. But this is someone that they know what they want. And it could have been where you guys may have been younger and it never worked out, because, you know, when you're young, you don't really know what's ahead. And now that they've matured, they've got their sights set on you. You know, we've got two knights here. These are action takers. These are communication cards. So tell me about the Knight of Swords now. Play Spirit. Tell me about the Knight of Swords. King of Pentacles, Queen of Pentacles, we've got a pair. This is a couple. Loving it. Princess of Pentacles and the Knight of Pentacles. Oh, what the heck is going on? And then the High Priestess. You've got the Knight of Pentacles, the King of Pentacles here, and the Queen of Pentacles. They're a pair. They're two people seeing eye to eye. They're two people that are, you know, are in a couple together, and they, you know, they're well suited because they are a pair. And with the King of Pentacles, this is somebody's, you know, it could be somebody's husband. This is someone that wants to look after, you know, the Queen of Pentacles, and the King of Pentacles knows the worth, the value of the Queen of Pentacles. They can see her worth, you know, she's valuable to him. And when I just said, now I'm seeing it, okay, thanks for it. When I said that I feel like you guys knew each other when you were younger, you've got the pages here. So you've got the female and the male here. And I feel like it didn't work out when you were younger, you know. I feel like maybe you were still at school, that maybe you were too young for this Knight of Pentacles. Maybe they were too slow to come forward and communicate with you how they felt. They took their time, and it could have ended up causing a separation here, which caused the despair. We've got a lot of earth energy here. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn here. We have I feel like you guys have a telepathic like you two telepathically communicate with one another, because we've got the High Priestess here. It's like you talk to each other. So it could be that you talk to each other in your dreams. You know, we've got three knights here. These are action takers. Yes, the Knight of Pentacles is slow in coming forward. That he's the slowest one in the deck. But it could be that he took his time and he's coming forward, because now we've got the Knight of Cups and the Knight of Swords here, which is action takers. Just bear with me, guys. I need to use another deck. I need to clarify. Tell me about this King of Pentacles here. Tell me about the King of Pentacles. out the King of Pentacles, please, Spirit. The World. The Star. Four of Swords. Eight of Cauldrons. Okay, this chapter was closed, like I said. You guys knew each other a while ago, a long time ago. And now they see yourself, they see who you are now, and they've had a change of heart. You know, this could have taken years even, okay? They now see you for who you are. They see you as the Star, Aquarius energy here. Someone that is a wish come true, basically. And they want you. And with the Four of Swords, there's no action being taken just yet. Things have been at a standstill here. Just cover that. Things have been at a standstill for you guys. Like I said, I feel like you've not seen each other for a long time. Now, what are they walking away from? What are they leaving behind? They're closing a chapter out in their life. I need to just cover those bits there. I don't want to get in trouble. They're closing a chapter in their life. They've been enlightened to you. They're leaving. It could be situation behind. It could be relationships behind. It could be, you know, it could be anything. I'll clarify that. So, yeah, they're closing this chapter because they've been enlightened about you. They know that you're their happiness here. So, let me clarify the Eight of Cups. What are they walking away from, Spirit? And then I'm going to do the Lovers in the main now. What are they walking away from? Swords defeated. Two of Wands. Seven of Cups. Yeah, like I said, with the Five of Swords as well, they're ending something here. What are you ending? They're putting their burdens behind them. Chariot again. They're ending something here. They've weighed up the pros and cons. They've weighed up their options here. And they've been doing this for quite a while. So they've been weighing up their pros and cons. You know, they're having to make a decision. And they know they've got to stick with this. But they know they've got to choose the right path for them. Okay? They know that from what I'm seeing from this card here, the Seven of Cups, is that you are the only option. They don't want anything else. Look at the rose in that cup right there. Never noticed that rose before. And the actual figure, if you look here, is actually looking at that rose there. So, you know, they've got all these offers here, or they've got all these opportunities or options here, but they don't want that anymore. They want that final cup right there, which is you. So they're leaving all this behind. They're leaving the Eight of Cups behind. You know, a lot of energy and effort's gone into their life, but they're leaving it behind. They don't want it anymore. And they're finally admitting to themselves that they've got to put an end to this. Because it's brought nothing but burdens throughout their life. Nothing but stress. We've had this twice now, the Ten of Wands. They've carried this around with them. They've missed, you know, I feel like they've missed you for so long. And they want to bury this. They want to bury the burdens. God, I'm making a right bloody mess, but never mind. Tell me about the Lovers and the main male, please, Spirit. Tell me about the Lovers and the main male. Five of Wands. Tell me about that the love is in the main male. Sorry about the love is in the main male case. Tell me about this Five of Wands. Just bear with me, guys, okay? Tell me about the Five of Wands. Tell me about the Five of Wands. Okay, right, so what I've got with the main male and the lovers here, they want to offer you this cup of love, okay, because it's all about, you know, their feelings and their emotions, and they want to express this to you. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces here. We've also got Virgo here as well. So they want to express this love that they have for you. They do want to come forward and communicate with you. They also want to be fair to you, you know. They want it to be equal give and take. The problem at the moment, the reason why this person's not come forward yet, why they're taking their time, you know, but we've already seen that they're walking away here. They have a family. They've put a lot of effort, energy and effort. They have a family. So it could have been that third party that I said at the beginning. It could have been that they left you for somebody else. They didn't see your worth at the time, but they see it now, right? So they've invested a long time, you know. This could even be more than 10 years, guys. They have children with this person. They built a life with this person. And they've gone quiet at the moment. The reason why they're being a bit, I feel like they're being a bit sneaky. I feel like they're trying to figure out how to do it that it doesn't come back on you and it doesn't come back on them if they do move forward with you, that they can just clear the slate and move forward and have peace with you. Because the Five of Wands is here. The Five of Wands speaks of conflict, of outsiders getting involved, of causing arguments, you know, it's a like a backlash, basically. It could even be that they're trying to act like nothing's going on, you know, they're not talking to anybody because this is like the hermit mode, you know. Merlin is the hermit. It's being on your own, thinking things through yourself. It could be that they know that other people wouldn't agree with this. It could be that they'll try and talk them out of this, you know, think about your family, but they're not happy. They're really not happy in this connection. So for some of them, it could even be that they're going through a divorce at the moment. And then you have the Six of Cups. The Six of Cups speaks of, look, we've got a pair again. King of Cups, Queen of Cups. We've got pairs here. So not only does this main male see you as someone that is stable, someone that can bring security into their life, that's balanced, that's humble, you know, kind, generous, successful, independent. You know, I'm bigging you up here, guys. You're also very loving, you're very kind, compassionate. You know, you've got that side of you as well that they love about you. Then you've got the Six of Cups. This, I feel like this is a past connection with both of you. This is like childhood memories, you know. It's thinking about the past, it's reunions, reconciliations, but I'm picking up strong vibes that this was someone from when you were a lot younger, some like an innocent kind of love. And but it's like they didn't see you, you know. What is the main male's next move, spirit? I mean, I can see some of it, but what is their next move towards my pile freeze? What's the next move? What's the main male's next move? equals 7. Tell me about the 7 of Shields. We've had the King of Pentacles come out twice. 10 of Shields. Tell me more about the 7 of Shields, please. No, I don't really need to ask, but go on, get one more. Tell me more about this 7 of Shields. No, actually, I don't need to. Look, the world again. So basically what I've just seen here is the King of Pentacles doesn't see this going anywhere, not with you, with whoever they're involved with. It's like it's just no growth. There's nothing. It's like he's not satisfied. It feels like it's failing, or it's already failed. Hence why we've got the world on the back of the deck again. The world is closing of a chapter. They want to close this chapter because it's not doing them any good. It's not doing them any favours. They're not feeling satisfied in life. They've got the 10 of Pentacles here. The 10 of Pentacles speaks of generational wealth. It's about a serious commitment here, that two people are going to commit to one another and stay together. This is like lifelong commitment, stability, security. And I feel like this is what they thought they were going to get with this, with whoever they got involved with. But that's not the case. It's like she's looking over her shoulder. She's looking at somebody else. And that's what I'm feeling like. They're drawn to you. Tell me about the 10 of Pentacles. You're their missing link. You're their missing pentacle. Tell me about the 10 of Pentacles. Tell me about the 10 of Pentacles. I suppose we've had no aces. Page of Shields. Tell me about the Page of Justice. So the Page of Pentacles is usually, it's a good news card, and it's someone that's, coming up with a plan. So it could be how they want to move forward, and reach out to you or get to see you again. They're doing a lot of spying at the moment, and this is becoming a bit unhealthy with the Devil card on the back of the deck. They're obsessed with checking up on you online to see what you're up to. The news is actually delayed at the moment because they've got a lot of things going on there. They've got to deal with the karmic. They've got to deal with the karmic, basically. They've got to do what's right for him and for her, whatever. So yeah, they've got to do right by this other person in their life, and if they've got a family, they've got to do right by them. So tell me about the Justice here. This is Libra energy. Emperor, Six of Wands, Victory. Yeah, they've made a decision already. It's over. They don't want. Yeah, look, they don't want the. They don't want the karmic. Let's call them the karmic. And they've made a decision, and obviously the karmic's not happy about this. Obviously they could be brokenhearted, but this is an ending of a relationship. This is unrequited love. They don't love them. It turned toxic in the end. The Emperor felt chained to the karmic. And it could be just, life got in the way, and family, and that kind of thing, and that's how they ended up tied to them. But now they're breaking free. They want to break that chain here because they want to restore balance. They want to have success with you and bring back balance into their own life, as well as with you, with each other, with you and them. They've been pining for you. They've been waiting for you for a long, long time. It could be they're even looking for you now. You know, maybe they don't know where you are, but they're waiting with a lot of yearning here. Eight of Cups. Love it. Eight of Cups speaks of a second chance, and I do think you guys have been divinely guided towards one another for a second chance. You know, spirit, you know, this karmic justice here, basically, I feel like spirit is giving them a second chance to do it correctly this time. And you've got the Father here, which is the Emperor, which is a father, can be someone's husband, like I said, but it's someone that's taking action towards you, someone that's very passionate about you. You know, and they want victory with you. They want success with you. So, Spirit, what advice would you give my pile phrase? Okay. Wow, the King of Wands. Okay, that's very, very rude. Yeah, look, this is a high level connection here between you two. This is the Hierophant. I feel like you had to come back together to, you know, even if it has been years. I feel like a high level soulmate connection here with both of you. But it could also be that the Emperor wants to come back and speak their truth to you. They want forgiveness from you, or they're seeking forgiveness from someone that's in that's religious, you know, trying to find the answers to what they should do as well, seeking, you know, a high level priest for the answers. It could be that they're looking within themselves, because they are, you know, they could have gifts themselves, Ace of Swords, like this. So yeah, they want to speak their truth. And I feel like the truth has been revealed to them. I mean, even they may have even gone to a high priestess, you know, like tarot reader, someone like that, to get advice from them. But they are making a plan to bring communication towards you, because this is all about communication. This is speaking your truth. So I want to clarify that speaking your truth in a minute, but we've got fire sign here, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. We've got Aries again with the Emperor there. So yeah, this person finds you very passionate. They find you very attractive, and they're very passionate about you. And if anything, they're quite sexually, you know, they find you, look at the wand and look at the bit at the back of the chair, but we shouldn't be showing that. Let's put that over there. Anyways, so yeah, look, we've got the Knight of Wands as well. This is someone that's taking action. This is someone that is very passionate about you, and they're coming forward to communicate this with you. So you've literally had four knights, all action takers here. There's definite movement here, definite action being taken towards you. Because it's like, I'm not letting you go this time. So let me have a look at this Page of Swords. Tell me about the Page of Swords. Tell me about the Page of Swords. Okay. They're coming to tell you that they've ended things, that they've could be that they've changed, that they've they want a new beginning with you, because death is all about rebirth. It's all about starting again. Tell us about the Ace of Swords and death. Tell us about the Ace of Swords and death, please, Spirit. Five of Swords. Yeah, they're leaving it behind. They're done. They're walking away. The Knight of Pentacles again. Tell me more about the Ace of Swords. Tell me more about the Ace of Swords. Oh my goodness. Oh, need to cover that. We've got the king, we've got a pair, king of cups, nine of cups, which is wish fulfillment, sun, which is happiness, and yeah. So with the king of cups, this is someone that, you know, is all up in their emotions, they're in love, they want to speak this to you. The communication that's been no communication, it's been non-communication with both of you for a very long time, that's about to come to an end. That's what the death is as well. They want to come forward, they want to end this silence between both of you. They're admitting defeat, they're admitting to themselves that they have to leave behind what's not serving them anymore, what's not doing, you know, not doing them any good, you know. And this came out of nowhere. I feel like this emperor here decided, like, crap, I need to do something, and I need to do it now. And they know they've got to destroy what they've built up with somebody else to come forward and, you know, be with you or speak to you. You know they've got to do that. They see you as wish fulfillment. They see you as their happiness here. You bring them joy, which is the sun. They've been enlightened to this. I mean, and the nine of swords here at the back of it speaks of, you know, over the years, if it's been years for you guys, they've done a lot of soul searching. They've grieved over not having you. They've beat themselves up over how they treated you, that they didn't give you a chance. You know, they're haunted by it. And I feel like spirit is actually spirit does it on purpose. I feel like because they made a big mistake. They went with a karmic instead of a soulmate. Or a twin flame, if you believe in that. So yeah, they stay up late at night and they think about what could have been. But I feel like they just want to put it to bed, lay it to rest now. Knight of Cups, once again, we've got the Knight of Cups twice now. Bloody hell, look at this. Yes, you're not going to expect this. This is going to come out of nowhere. This is like literally the tower is something that happens so suddenly, so it's very quick. You're not going to see this coming. This is the Knight of Cups. Once again, we've got at the beginning of the thingy that's coming to speak to you about their feelings, to communicate to you how they feel. And this is a soulmate connection here. This is two people that have mutual feelings for each other that, you know, are in love. So let's get some of these cards here. Spirit, what messages do you have for my pile three? So just expect communication. There was a lot of communication in this. You know, expect the unexpected, basically. I feel like your past is coming back. Give your relationship a chance. Work on the partnership. So, you know, maybe you're worried about giving this person a chance. That could be why the despair's there as well. You know, mental tension, like a confusion. That should I trust them? Can I trust them? Maybe they've got too much baggage that you don't want to take on yourself. It could be, like I said, it could be that you've got to move away to be closer to where they are. Maybe because they've got children. You know, and that disrupts your life as well. Honeymoon. Enjoy the bliss of a holiday time together. So it could be that you meet them again on holiday. That is a chance, because with the Kipper cards, it did say that there is a journey. There's travel there. But it could be that you're going to be, when you come back together, it's like a honeymoon period, you know, like how it was when you first were with one another or first saw each other. So we've got children. Your love life, that's what I just said. I feel like what is being affected or what could affect this relationship is children. Pay attention to the red flags. The signs are cautioning you. Ooh, okay. What's this red flag? So just be careful. Don't be blinded by this person coming in and you're like, you know, oh my God, I haven't seen you in ages, blah, blah, blah. Do not ignore the red flags. If there's red flags there, pay attention to them. You know, this person... I didn't see anything negative though in the reading. So engagement, your life is ascending to a high level of commitment. So yeah, you could end up getting engaged to this person, you could end up getting married. Maybe that's why you're going on a honeymoon together. Passion, allow your heart, soul, to sing with joy. But just be careful with red flags here, okay? So let's get some charms. If you don't like the noise, turn down the volume. So we have, so the letters could be in their name, it could be their initials, or it could even be yours. We've got L, I, C, Q, O, X, S, P. So they're the letters that came out. You've got quite a lot of charms there. So that could be in their name or their initials. So that's that there. So then we've got a key, another key, yeah. So I do believe that you two have always held a special place in each other's heart for each other, that you've both you've held the key to his heart, and she's held the key to his heart. He's held the key to your heart. There you go. And then we've got the cat. The cat is all about good luck. So this could be a good luck connection, or it could be good luck that's coming towards you. You've got another good luck charm in here, which is the horseshoe. Horseshoe's all about good luck. You've got the star, which is all about the star card, success, abundance. Wishes coming true. There's quite a lot of wishes coming true. You've got love. So this is a love connection here. Two people being in love, which we've got the two cups. You've got Big Ben. Yeah, you've got Big Ben. Maybe you're going to be visiting the UK if you guys are not from the UK. It could be you could have a day out in London, or you could meet up with this person in London. Your first meeting after all these years. You've got the palm trees here. So this is something that can grow into something beautiful. You know, look at all the abundant fruit on the tree here, the coconuts. Or it could even be that you're going abroad, because we've had quite a lot of travel cards here, like the chariot with the journey and things like that. So it could be that maybe something to do with Caribbean, or it could have something, a place where there's palm trees. It's very funny when I see this, because I'm Turkish, so our flag is actually the sun and the moon. I mean the star and the moon. So it could be someone that is maybe Turkish, or it could just be like the star card again, you know, wishes coming true. And then we've got angel wings. Is that angel wings? Yeah, this is being divinely guided. It could be that we've got the spoon and the fork here. So I think maybe they're going to invite you out to dinner, you know, maybe take you out for something to eat. We've got fish, which is abundance, success, and we've got the cross in the fish as well. So I think you're both protected. This connection is protected. We've got children here as well. So yeah, I do believe children are involved in this connection. It could even be that you've got children as well. This has been slow to come because we've got the tortoise here. You know, the tortoise is very slow moving energy. So this has taken a very, very long time to happen. You've got the robin here. So it could be that your spirit guides, or mainly your angels, to see the robin as your passed over loved ones that are protecting you. You know, they're there with you. And then you've got yin and yang. You're each other's other half. And what the heck is that? Is it broken? I think that's actually broken. But then again, I actually see that as waves. Like the tower. Something unexpected is going to come towards you. But I'm not putting that back in there. I look stupid. But anyway, so I'm going to leave it there, pile three. If this resonated, please hit like and comment down below. And I'll see you soon. Bye.